In today's video, I'm going to show you how to create that really cool retro ViewMaster photo slideshow effect. Let's get into it. Hey everyone, Kelsey here, and welcome back to Gal. So in one of Dan Mace's recent videos, he took out a ViewMaster and did this really cool slideshow effect, and it brought back some memories, and I was like, oh, I remember having one of those. So I thought it would be cool to actually create this effect in Premiere Pro and show you how it works. Now I've put together a whole photo slideshow pack that's available on my store, and I added this effect to that pack. You can go to premieregal.com/store to go check out my photo slideshow pack to see if it's something you wanna add to your video editing tool belt. Also, I want to thank Hostinger for sponsoring today's tutorial. I will tell you more about them later on, but for now, let's go ahead and jump into Premiere Pro. So this photo here that I have in my timeline is from Disneyland. If you want to use these same files and see the final effect, you can sign up to become a patron and download all of my demo project files to follow along for free, and I'll put a link just down below. So what I'm going to do is actually create a color mat first, and we're going to apply a mask on top of that. Go to the negative space in your project window, control click or right click, go to new item, color mat. And I'm just going to hit okay and make it black. Then we can drag and drop it on top of the clip. Now I only want this to be 2 seconds long, so I'm going to type in exactly 2 seconds here into the time code. And then I'm just going to press shift to cut both of these layers, then go back to the selection tool by pressing V and delete these excess clips. So now it's just a black mat. If we turn off this layer, the photo's beneath. So what we wanna do is create a square photo mask on top of this color mat. So go to Effect Controls, and underneath Opacity, select Create 4-Point Polygon Mask. We still have some more work to do. Firstly, we need to invert it, because we want the photo to be inside of the mask. The next thing we can do is scale it up. To scale this up, go to the corner until you get that rotation symbol, press Shift, and then click to scale this up. Now we need to make it more square, so now we need to expand the edges here. So I'm gonna click and lasso and select the top two, and then click, then press shift to bring this up so it's proportional. And I'll do the same at the bottom. So now we roughly have a square. Now I know this is kind of annoying. I've pointed it out to Adobe. Why can't we just make a square mask from the beginning? Fingers crossed, it is happening soon. So now that we have our base, I'm gonna go up to mask expansion and just click on this number and roll this out until we get the rounded edges. You can add as much as you need to until it looks right for the look that you're going for. So I think this looks pretty good. And then the good thing about using the color mat when the mask is beneath this, we have our photo. So we can go up to motion and then reposition it inside of the mask so it looks better in the frame that we need. The next thing we're going to do is add some noise and some color adjustments to make it look a little bit more retro. So I'm gonna move up the color mat onto video layer 3. Again, I'm going to control click and right click on the negative space, then go to adjustment layer and drag the adjustment layer onto video layer 2, cut off the excess here. And then from effects, I'm going to search for noise. Drag and drop it onto the adjustment layer. And now I'm gonna add in about 20% of grain. And now you can see that it looks a little bit more retro. Another thing that we can do is add a channel blur. So from here, we can play around with the RGB blurriness. Underneath red, if I open this up, if I increase this, you can see it brings out some green halos around the image, kind of distorting it. And this will vary photo to photo. It's going to look a little bit different. So you can apply the channel blur if you want this type of effect. Another thing that you can do is go over to the Lumetri color panel, and from Creative, the look dropdown, we can apply one of these film filters. So for example, the Fuji F125 codec, if we apply that, it will also give it a more film-like look. So now we need to do the animation and the keyframing. But before we do that, we need to nest it so it's one layer, so it's going to be easier to animate. So click and lasso and select all three layers at once. Then you can go up to clip and select nest, and we can create our first slide nest. And now we have just one layer. And if we double click and open this up, all three layers exist within that one layer. So going back into our main timeline here, this is where we can use effect controls on just this one layer to create our animation. So to make the rotation easier, I'm going to first change the anchor point. So if you select the anchor point, you can see it's just in the center. What I'm going to do is actually move this anchor point to the corner of the photo. So that way, when we rotate it, it rotates from the corner. Of course, we're going to animate the position too. We're going to move to the out point. So around here, we can always change this later on. This is where we want the photo to end up. So I'm going to set a keyframe, turn on the toggle animation on rotation, also on position, because this is going to be the end point. Then we're going to go back to the beginning, and this is where I'm going to rotate this up. And I also want the photo to move up. So using this vertical position here, I'm going to move this up out of frame. So that way it just rotates in, and it happens pretty quick because it's a very quick slide. But if you want it to be slower, you can always lasso and select these two keyframes and drag it out. To make it a little bit more smooth, you can control click or right click on these keyframes and ease in. Another thing you can do between these two points is add a Gaussian blur. So that way during the motion part, it's a little bit more blurry. So I'm going to go to effects and search for Gaussian blur and drag and drop it onto slide one. And then we want it to be blurry from the beginning, so we can increase it to 100, set a keyframe, then as it goes in, bring it down to zero. This is what it looks like. Now we need to do the exact same thing, but at the very end of our slide here. So again, we're going to set keyframes on the position and the rotation, also set a keyframe on the blurriness because we want it to get blurry. And then let's move to the end of this clip. And once again, we're going to rotate it off screen. We also see right here that there's a problematic line happening here. I will show you how to fix this in just a second. But first, let's finish the animation here. We can move this down and off to the left, so that way it'll move down. And then we can move this over. So we did the rotation and the position, and now we just need to add the Gaussian blur. So right around here, let's increase this back up to 100. The next thing we need to do is get rid of this line here. To get rid of this line, we need to go into the nested sequence here, into slide one, and we need to scale up the color mat slightly. So we can go in here and we can scale this up to 102, for example. And let's go back to the demo here, and look at that, it disappeared. So that's how you animate one photo, but what about multiple photos? What if you want to see the second photo come in as the first photo animates out? That's what I'm going to show you how to do next, but first I'm going to tell you about today's sponsor, Hostinger. So as a video creator and a video editor, having a website is a great way to bring in new clients, but web hosting is very expensive. And about 2 years ago, I discovered a new platform called Hostinger that makes web hosting more affordable to creators. For a premium hosting plan, it just costs $2.99 per month. And comparing this to other web hosting platforms that cost $15 per month, this is a great deal. Plus, with the hosting, you get a free domain, you get a free professional email with that domain, you get 100 gigabytes of storage and unlimited bandwidth and a whole lot more. Hostinger also has an integration with WordPress, so you can install WordPress and then use your favorite themes to build your video editing portfolio. You can use my link hostinger.com/gal to go check out web hosting plans and use my discount code GAL to get an additional 10% off. If you want some ideas for how to create a great video editing portfolio, you can watch my video right up here where I review 4 different creative portfolios and break down the top things that you need in your portfolio. Thanks so much to Hostinger for sponsoring today's video, and now let's get back into the tutorial. Now let's go back into our project panel and let's take another photo here. Let's say Thunder Mountain from Disneyland. Let's drag and drop this and let's roll it in so it's the same length as the image below, 2 seconds, and then we can move this over. And let's choose one more, the Jungle Cruise. Then we can go back into our nested sequence, double click to open that up, and lasso and select the color mat and the adjustment layer, Command C or Control C on a PC, then press Command V to paste it, and let's bring this over on the first one, and then one more time, paste it, and drag it on the second clip. And now we're going to nest these as well. We'll call this slide two, and let's do the same thing with the last group. So now on these two photos, we're going to copy and paste the animation. So on this slide, this animation here, we're going to press Command C or Control C to copy, and then lasso and select these two other slide nests that we just created and control click or right click, and we're not going to paste, we're going to paste attributes. And here we're just going to paste the motion and the blur. So hit OK. So now this has the animation. But then you're looking at this one, wait, what happened to the mask? Well, it turns out that this photo is just smaller than the mask, so we have to go back in and go to this photo and just scale it up so it fits inside of our mask because the mask was actually bigger. But what about having them come in at the same time? So as this animates out, we see part of the second photo. So this is where we can stack them. So as this comes out, we can bring up slide 2 to video layer 2 and then bring it over. And a good tip I have is pressing option and the left arrow bracket key to move over frame by frame until we see it. And look at this, we have a beautiful ViewMaster effect, and it's not that complicated. It's actually pretty easy to do. And to add the frosting on the cake here, this is where we can go in and add this sound effect. By the way, if you purchase my photo slideshow effect, this sound effect comes with it, and we can just take this slideshow sound. It's actually a camera shutter, but it kind of sounds like the slide effect. Just bring this down here, and we can duplicate it at each slide point. So I can press option, drag it to duplicate it, and now it has the sound effects. Pretty cool. So my photo slideshow pack comes with 10 placeholders with this exact animation and the sound effect. Plus it comes with 6 other different types of photo animations that emulate a similar style to Johnny Harris's documentaries on YouTube. So you're not just going to get this animation, but a bunch of others in different aspect ratios as well. So to import the template after you download it, you can just drag and drop the project file into your project window and then just press create new folder and allow for duplicate media, and you can just import the entire project here. And once it's imported, it creates this folder, and then you can double click on all slides. And here you can see that there's a placeholder here. So you can double click on the slide, and you can delete this text placeholder, and then drag in your own photo, for example, this photo here. And then you can scale it into the color mat, just like that. So my template just makes it easier to go in and just drag and drop your placeholders so you don't have to create it from scratch. But I also have 2 more announcements. One, I launched an editing magic competition. If you go to premieregal.com/competitions, you can check out all of the sponsors. Right now we have over $1,750 worth of editing prizes that you can win. You just need to edit a 15-second optical illusion or visually interesting piece that also uses sound effects. Enter your submission. There's going to be 3 winners, so each winner will win all of the prizes that you see on the page, and the deadline is May 15th, and I'll be announcing the winners at the end of May. My second announcement is you should go check out my Super Peer page at superpeer.com/gal. You can book one-on-one trainings with me. I also host live office hours, as well as some topical streams where you could do like a deep dive into a topic, so it's not just like a quick video on demand on YouTube, but we can really go in and you can ask questions live. So you can subscribe, become a paid subscriber to my Super Peer to access those streams and the office hours. That's all for today's video. You can click right over here to watch some more tutorials or click right over here on my profile to subscribe to this channel. And as always, keep creating better video with Gal. See you next time. Bye.